E agora, ligando a esse tema de inclusão e tecnologia, a gente vai falar sobre uma coisa tão importante, que é
Por
o
acaso
futuro
passou
dos
nota com você?
negócios. E o nosso palestrante de agora vai provar para a gente que não vale a pena e nem é possível fazer negócios no futuro se eles não forem sustentáveis. Se eu não pensar em sustentabilidade, não existe negócio no futuro. Talvez não exista nem futuro. Então, a gente vai dar as boas-vindas ao Lian Siebenbergen. I don't know how to say your name perfectly. I'm sorry. E ele é um serial entrepreneur. Ele já fundou mais de 20 empresas e também é o fundador da B-Lab da Europa, que, para quem nunca ouviu falar em Sistema B, é um sistema, um selo que a gente dá para as empresas que são responsáveis. Ambiental e socialmente, culturalmente. E ele é o nosso grande entendedor do assunto, que vai falar aqui, trazendo de forma bem concreta e falando das empresas que ele conhece muito de perto e ajudou a fundar, sobre o futuro dos negócios. Welcome.
Thank you. We don't have enough time to talk about different kinds of business. And I assume those are all the business people from Rio. Huh? Is that correct? You are the new business people from Rio. So what I want to talk to you about is a little bit about sustainability and things that you probably don't know. Maybe some of you do, but most of you probably don't. About 125 years ago, and I have to do this when they have to move to the next slide because I don't have a clicker. About 125 years ago, people really started to care about nature. And then you can say, did people not care before that? People did care before that, but they didn't do anything. And I wrote a book, which is called Rip Off Your Necktie and Dance, about new forms of doing business. 100,000 people bought the book. Did anything change in the world? Did you see any change in the world? Nothing is changing in the world. There are people here in this building that think that things are changing. Go into Rio and ask people about sustainability. Nothing is happening. Nothing is happening. Nothing. Nowhere in the world. And why is that nothing is happening? Please go on with the slides. Click and click. People don't do anything because there is no real crisis. There are many crises in the world, but many people don't feel it. So, has anybody heard about the Club of Rome? Club of Rome? Nobody has heard of the Club of Rome? See how influential all those people are. Those are the most influential intellectuals who came together 50 years ago in Rome to create a new club of people who care about the world. They even wrote a book, Limits to Growth. 900,000 people bought the book. Did anything change? Nothing changed. We go to the next one. And that is a club of people that's called Social Venture Network. Those are business people like you, I hope. And the business people I know, and you maybe know, are the people that are going to change the world. The change makers, and this is scientifically proven, of the world are going to be the business people. So I have my hopes on the business people. Social Venture Network is the oldest network globally of people that want to change the world. Ben Cohen, you know Ben and Jerry's? Anybody knows ice cream? Ice cream? You know ice cream? You're the only one eating ice cream? You see, you know Ben Cohen. He founded Ben and Jerry's. He is a business person and he is an activist. He wants to change the world. He created Social Venture Network that probably none of you have heard of. We go to the next one. The next slide. The next. The next. Yeah, it's difficult, you know. And that is something that you might have heard of. You know the United Nations? Anybody you know? United Nations? United Nations? No? Okay, you know it. Good. They created something which is called the Millennium Goals. Have you heard of that? Eight goals that are going to change the world. How much has changed since they introduced those goals in the year 2000? Not much, because nobody knows them. And nobody knows what to do with them. So we go to the next one. And now we come to something interesting. One more click. And then you see people who created a new kind of business. There are 20 B Corps in Rio de Janeiro. 20. And the B Corps are the companies, click, that are going to change the world. They are the entrepreneurs that really are going to do something. Those are other examples. Ben and Jerry's, Kickstarter, Triodos Bank, Patagonia, Danone, all those kind of companies are B Corps. And why now are they changing the world? Because if you want to do business internationally with people in Europe, what do you think? How do I start? So we go to the next slide, and that shows our goals for 2030, the United Nations again, click. And what you see now is they invented 17 different goals even. Not 8 anymore, 17. Even more difficult for companies to do anything about. So we go to the next click. And here you see a first try of B Corps and the United Nations together to define the tasks for small businesses. Like small businesses in Rio. One person, two people, 10 people, small companies. Did you know that 99.6% of all the companies in the world are small companies, and 0.4 are the big companies that you know. The funny thing about this is that the big companies think big about themselves, and they think they're important. They're highly influential in governments. They're highly influential in blocking new laws. But they are very small in numbers. So I want to go to the next slides, the next group of slides, and I quickly want to run through it because I do not have much time. Click. Sorry that I have to do click. Have you heard about externalities? Does anybody know what an externality is? No? There is a woman laughing the whole the time. See, do you know? Yeah, you. You know what an externality is? Because you think it's maybe extremely funny, but an externality is something that nobody knows what it is. An externality is a cost that the shareholders of a company don't have to pay for. That is an I'm an accountant. I founded 20 different companies. I ran the largest IT company in Brazil. I know Brazil. I know companies. But I know that they don't care, big companies, normally. And an externality is something that they take advantage of the people. Let me give you an example. Also in Brazil, when people mine, they have to cut the forest, okay? So they cut the forest, they mine and leave. Who cleans it up? Who cleans that mess up, you think? Do you know? The government does. And who pays for it? You do. Congratulations. That is your gift of the day. You pay for the cost, the stakeholders pay for the cost, and the shareholders take the profit. And that is one of the biggest mistakes in the whole economical system nowadays. And it happens all over the world. Let me give you an example from the Netherlands. I'm from the Netherlands. We found gas. You also probably found gas in Brazil. And we found gas under the soil, of course, and we pumped it up. We pumped it up for 30 years, and then the houses started to tumble. We had earthquakes in the Netherlands. We never had earthquakes. And why were the earthquakes? They took the gas out, and the soil went down. The houses started to... Who paid for that? All of us. We do. Who took the profit of the gas? The gas company. And that is something that is called an externality. And that is completely wrong. And those externalities are costful. And those are the crises. And as long as the crisis is not big enough, we will not change. Unfortunately, we will not change. And we see many crises. Eh? Have you heard of a tsunami in Indonesia a month ago? Did you hear about it? You heard about the tsunami. Anybody else? And then we started to raise money. Only in the Netherlands alone, they raised 11 million euro for the people in Indonesia after the tsunami. Do you understand what I'm saying? After the tsunami. Why not before? We knew that the systems to detect a tsunami were rotten, but we didn't put money in. There was no crisis. So now I want to go to something that is more that will make you more happy. We go on. Yeah, this is how difficult it is to change. As you can see, I don't know if you see the pictures and the difficulty. We go on next slide. Those are the people. And the reason why I show those pictures of smiling, happy people is that doing business, and I know it because I've done it in 20 different companies, you do with people that you trust. So, who do you trust? Well, I have made so many mistakes that I've lost millions of dollars because I thought I could trust people. Women know much better who to trust than men. So my wife always corrects me when I trust somebody. I say, well, this is somebody I can really trust. I can really do business. And she said, no, I don't think so. And every time when I did it, I lost money. So trust is very important in doing business. And if you want to do business with people in Europe, and if people in Europe want to do business with people here, people think Brazil is corrupt. Well, you know it's not true, huh? There is no corruption here in Brazil. But the people in Europe, they are afraid to do business in Brazil because they think it's corrupt. Who can they trust? Who can they trust? So now we go back to the B Corps. The B Corps, click, is a community of people, 120 in Brazil. Oh, I didn't know what he was doing. Sorry. Now I see what he is. He's translating. And click. Yeah, how do you do click? Click. Oh, click. Good. I won back, sorry. We exercised the click a little bit. So if you go back to the people and the people who inspire you, the question that was asked to me and the presentation that I'm also going to give in Chile next week is about 200 of B Corps in Chile. I think there are 200 or 300 B Corps in Chile alone. And there is about 700 all over South America. How can they do business? So what I want to tell you and show you is some companies, we go on, companies that want to do business with you. To make it very concrete, a B Corp, you have to imagine, is a company that is certified. And the people who run those B Corps have the same values as you. They care for the planet. They want to make a change, and they have a company with a purpose. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that you would work for a company that has no purpose? A friend of mine was working for BAT. Have you heard of BAT? British American Tobacco. It is a company that has a purpose to kill people. Can you imagine that you work for that? Hey, you go to a birthday party and they say, hey, how many people did you kill this year? A million or more. And everybody starts to clap. Wow. So a company with a purpose is a company that can attract millennials. It is proven by now that the companies in the world that have a purpose can attract talented people. And that is very valuable. And a company with a purpose has a set of values that you can recognize. Because I can assure you that Dutch companies, small companies, or French companies, or English companies, have the same values as the people here in this audience. And then they are certified as a B Corp. So I want to show you five companies that have asked me, if you're going to Rio Lane, present us to the audience and ask them if they want to do business with us. So click. Click. Yeah, this is one company. It is a company called Waka Waka. And Waka Waka is a very funny company. It's almost a social enterprise. You know what a social enterprise is. It has a product that is this small, and that is a light. A light on solar. So it's a battery and a light in one. It is a hugely successful company. Why is that? Because they provide children, as you can see, people all over the world, with lights in the evening. Well, how special is that? I can tell you that the biggest form in pollution in African families is because they have to light a light, kerosene, or a fire. And people die from that. and Hertzburn. So they have a product that is lying here that is called Waka Waka that they sell all over South America. It is here. So what they are looking for is for companies that say, we like that. We see the purpose in this and we want to do business. And I assure you, I don't make any money of it. I only have the product here. So if there is one company in Rio that says, hey, this is nice for people in this country, then you can do business with this man. His name is Maurits Groen. In the Netherlands, he is a local hero. A local, because the Netherlands is a very, very small country. Maybe you have ever heard of it. It's very, very tiny. As many people in the whole country, probably almost as you have in Rio. So, which is almost a country in itself, of course. So that is Maurits. The second, click, we go to the second company. That is very sexy as well. You know what this is? This is a little notebook, you see? It has pages in it, and you can write on it. Did you know that the paper industry, which is very big in Brazil, is one of the biggest polluting industries in the planet? Did you know that? They pollute water. They cut trees. The recyclability is very small on paper. So what is this? It looks like paper, but it isn't. It's made out of stone. 80% stone powder and 20% bioplastic. It's called stone paper. It's actually a strange word. And you can write. You don't need a hammer and a thing to click, 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 on the stone to make letters. You can write on it. It feels like high quality paper. This woman, her name is Anna, founded this company and is doing amazing. She wins award after award with her company. And she is looking for partners all over the world who say, well, we like this product and we like to sell this. Because this is an immediate improvement on the planet. So I have some notebooks here for people interested. From all those people, I have business cards. So if you want to pick up a business card, pick it up. Click, we go to the next one. And that is a company called Dopper. This is, click. Maybe they have left. Oh no, this is Dopper. Yeah, not the person, Dopper. In Europe, I don't know how it is here, people buy plastic bottles of water and they think it's cool that they walk around with their bottles of water and they drink, and when the bottle is empty, they throw it away into the ocean. You know, have you heard of plastic soup? The plastic problem is gigantic. In the Netherlands, the water that comes out of the tap is better quality than the water that is in the plastic bottles. So Dopper has invented this bottle, and this bottle is selling all over the world. It's a huge hit. Millions and millions of those bottles that they refill and refill and refill with water. The idea is very simple. So it's more of a marketing concept. It helps because it fights the plastic problem that we have. The guy is very nice. His name is Marijn. He works all over the world. You see the website there. And he produces those. He also would love to work with companies from Rio. Next one, called Farm Brothers. Farm Brothers produce cookies. Hey, that is nice. But cookies is a different kind of problem. Because people all over the world, when they buy something, they think, what am I buying when I eat? In the Netherlands, when people buy chicken, they are not even certain if that chicken is made of a chicken. If it is not made out of a cow or a horse, and if it is not filled with water, they put in it to raise the weight. So actually they drink chicken. And that is a big problem. Food is going to be a huge problem in this planet. So this company is two brothers in the Netherlands. They have a farm and they produce organic products, organic cookies, less fat, no palm oil, of course, and all kinds of other ingredients that are healthy. And also those two brothers, they make a big impact in stores. They get a lot of store space because the stores are slowly changing as well. And why is that? Because the consumers are changing slowly as well. So Farm Brothers. Anybody interested? Pick up a business card, eat a cookie. They tasted amazingly well. Sometimes those organic products are bleh, and that is, but this is pretty good. It's a pretty good product. So finally, a technology company, click, called Fize or Fize or what you want to do. It is, they call it, it's the next slide. It is smart windows on buildings. And smart windows on buildings that the window produces the electricity as well. So this is for technology people who believe in renewable energy. I do. They can import this product. It's a well-patented invention that actually creates with the whole facade of a building. You see those buildings there. The whole facade of the building is made out of a totally different kind of glass that takes all the solar energy. And you have a lot of sun here. At least that's people told me until I arrived, because now it rains every day. So if you see those five companies are only five examples. What is the nice thing about those companies, you think? The nice thing is that the people are so nice. They are not crooks. They have the same value system as you. They are like you, and you would like them. So it's very easy to do business. And I can tell you that it is the most underestimated asset in doing business is how can I trust people? Finally, I am the founder of B-Lab Europe. So we have 600 B-Corps in Europe, and we have 700 B-Corps in the pipeline, companies that want to become a B-Corp. So it's a huge, explosive growth of companies. And those people, it's the people, want to change the planet. They want to make something that is better for all of us. So if you say, hey, I have the same value set, and I would like to do business in Europe, come to me, and I will introduce you to those 600 companies in Europe that want to help you. There is a person from Argentina, his name is Pedro Tarac. Pedro Tarac, some of you maybe have heard of him. He is one of the founders of the B Sistema B movement. That is the B Corp movement in South America. And he is a fantastic man. He is a real philosopher. He is a very honest man. And he came to Europe with a delegation of South American entrepreneurs to do business there. And that is something that is lacking. It is so simple to do business with people that you like that it is amazing how little that happens. So, having said that, I could speak for hours and hours about the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, about the B Corps that we have, the B Corp movement that is also widely represented here in this conference. But I would like to invite all of you, if you're really interested, pick up some stuff here, do business, and really start doing something. Because it is only you who can change this planet, nobody else. Thank you.